8 perennial fruits and veggies to plant once and harvest for years. Growing vegetables and fruits in the home garden is rewarding, but many people are put off by the back-breaking work involved at the start of the growing season. Perennial edibles are the answer to this problem. Here are 8 fruits and veggies that will keep coming back year after year. 1. Sweet potatoes. Sweet potatoes are usually grown as annuals in cooler climates, but the vine can live as a perennial in the same spot for years in warmer areas. Grow sweet potatoes from rooted cuttings you get from garden centers, or make your own planting material by allowing the tubers to sprout and put out many runners. Although sweet potato vine can grow in poor soil, it gives plentiful harvest if the soil is loose and fertile. 2. Blueberry. This North American native deserves to be part of every edible garden. Once established, a blueberry plant can provide berries for several decades. Blueberry bushes are acid-loving, they grow best in soils with pH 5. It should be evenly moist and well-drained. Occasional pruning keeps the bushes healthy. 3. Asparagus. Asparagus is probably one of the most well-known perennial vegetables. It takes a few years until it begins producing at its best, but once established you will be enjoying a plethora of fresh shoots every spring. Although it is possible to start asparagus from seed, you can speed up the harvest timeline by planting asparagus crowns. 4. Alpine strawberries. Alpine strawberries are worth planting as a perennial fruit that also acts as a great ground cover. Similar to cultivated strawberries, alpine strawberries can be planted as crowns, and make a great edible addition to an otherwise ornamental garden. While not as productive as the cultivated variety, once ripe these berries are deliciously sweet garden treats. 5. Rhubarb. Although most people know of rhubarb in pie form, it is in fact a perennial vegetable with beautiful leaves and an edible stalk. Like asparagus, rhubarb is best planted from crowns and should be allowed to establish for a few years before harvesting. 6. Sorrel. A salad green often grown as an annual, but actually a perennial, can be harvested as soon as 60 days after planting. When the leaves are cut, it just keeps coming again. Be sure to remove the flowers to keep the plant producing leaves into autumn. 7. Daylilies. As any gardener will tell you, daylilies thrive on neglect. So much so, they have naturalized across the United States. While they are primarily grown as ornamentals in North America, they are grown as a vegetable in Asia, harvested for their daily profusion of flower buds, which are used like green beans. The flowers themselves are served in salads or battered and fried. 8. Currants. Currants are easy to grow perennial fruit for edible gardens. These cold hardy plants do very well in sunny locations in cooler areas and, in partial shade in warmer places, and reliably produce fruit every year from the second year of planting. They are generally grown from cuttings, and prefer moist, slightly acidic soil. Do you have any perennial edibles in your garden? Please share it in the comments below. Put vinegar on your plants and this will happen. There's a handy ingredient probably sitting in your pantry just waiting to provide an array of super benefits. Vinegar. Did you know you can safely use this ingredient in the garden too? Check out a few clever ways you can use vinegar, white and apple cider, where your veggies and plants spend their days. 1. Vinegar kill weeds. Instead of spending a lot of money on toxic chemicals to get rid of the weeds in your garden, pouring apple cider vinegar directly on the weeds. The acetic acid will stop weed growth without damaging the soil. 2. Get rid of ants. Ants don't like the smell of vinegar, so you can keep them at bay by mixing 1 part water and 1 part vinegar in a spray bottle and attacking ant hills with the solution. Both white vinegar and apple cider vinegar work well. 3. Freshen flowers. Cut a pretty bouquet of flowers from your garden and keep them fresh by adding 2 tablespoons of vinegar and a teaspoon of sugar to a quart of water, and add your flowers. 4. Feed your plants. Some plants, like gardenias, holly, and begonias, thrive on acidic soil. You can give those plants some extra love by spritzing with a mixture of 1 gallon of water with 1 cup of white vinegar. 5. Test the pH level of your soil. The acid levels in your soil can affect how well plants grow. You can run a simple test on your dirt by placing a bit of the soil in a container and then add 1/2 cup vinegar. If the vinegar begins to fizzle and bubble, the soil is too alkaline. Add sulfur or peat moss to even out the soil's acidity. 6. Remove allergens from your hands. If you've been digging in the dirt with your bare hands, make sure to rinse your hands with white distilled vinegar. The vinegar will remove allergens and other debris so you don't start itching. 7. Keep common pets out of your garden. Animals that love to get in your garden, like raccoons, rabbits, moles, rodents, and deer also happen to hate the smell of vinegar, so it will keep them out naturally without causing them harm. All you have to do is soak a few rags in your apple cider vinegar and place them strategically throughout your garden. Re-soak them once a week to ensure they retain their maximum effectiveness. And 8. Clean pots. Mix 1 part water, 1 part white distilled vinegar. Soak glazed, clay or plastic pots in the solution for at least an hour to remove stains and mineral deposits. Have you ever used vinegar in your yard? Please share your experience in the comments below. See what happens when you add Epsom salt to your plants. Epsom salt is a natural mineral that was first discovered in Epsom, England. People typically use Epsom salt in the bathroom to relieve aches and pains or internally as a laxative, but it is also a garden additive that expert gardeners swear by. It can help you produce lush, healthy plants, flowers and trees. Here are 7 amazing reasons to use Epsom salt in your garden. 1. Make fruit sweeter. Epsom salt, when added to trees, bushes and vines that produce fruit, boosts the chlorophyll inside the plant. When plants have more chlorophyll, they have more energy. When they have more energy, they produce more sugar. More sugar means sweeter fruit for you to enjoy. 2. Tree stump remover. Tree stump removal can be costly, but if you don't have the money to get a stump removed, let Epsom salt come to your rescue. Simply drill few holes into the stump and fill in the holes with Epsom salt. In weeks, the stump will begin rotting. 3. Epsom salt increases nutrient absorption. Many commercial fertilizers add magnesium to help plant roots take up vital nutrients, nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur. For those using all organic materials to feed their gardens, adding Epsom salt to soil will improve absorption naturally, eliminating the need for processed chemical fertilizers. 4. Lush lawn fertilizer. If your lawn isn't lush and beautiful, it probably needs a little magnesium in its life. To perk up grass, add 3 pounds of Epsom salt to every 1,250 square feet of grass and then water your lawn. 5. Beautiful blooming roses. Ever wonder why your neighbor's rose bushes are fuller than yours and sport so many more blossoms? It is highly likely that the answer is Epsom salt. Epsom salt to rose bushes encourages them to produce larger flowers with darker, deeper colors. To incorporate Epsom salt to your rose bush's diet, add it at the time of planting and when flowers are in bloom. 6. Keep leaves green. Plants that aren't getting enough magnesium can be identified by their yellowing leaves. This is because magnesium is an essential component in the production of chlorophyll. Try sprinkling Epsom salt around your plants to achieve healthier foliage. About 1 tablespoon per 12 inches of height once a month will benefit the plants in your vegetable garden, as well as any trees, shrubs, flowers, and grasses you want to green up. And 7. Produce abundant nightshades. Many people enjoy growing plants from the nightshade family such as peppers, tomatoes, eggplants and potatoes. All nightshades need a lot of magnesium, so that they produce greater yields. Epsom salt also helps improve the flavor of nightshades. To ensure the nightshades you grow in your home garden are abundant and tasty, add 1 tablespoon of Epsom salt to your peppers and tomatoes by sprinkling it around the base of the plant. If you want the salt to dissolve more quickly, add it to a gallon of water and water the plants with the mixture. You should continue to add the Epsom salt to your plants every 2 weeks. Now if you have any better ideas and suggestion of using Epsom salt in your garden, please share them in the comments below. You will never throw away banana peels after watching this. Human beings consume billions of bananas each year, making this peculiar yellow fruit one of the most popular foods in the world. However, those billions of bananas we eat result in billions of banana peels which are typically thrown away. Did you know banana peels make one of the best fertilizers out there? I didn't until I started researching it. Turns out, banana peels are a rich source of nutrients your plants crave, potassium, phosphorus, and calcium, along with a host of other minerals your plants need. Here are 6 ways to recycle your banana peels and never throw them away. 1. Compost. Probably the most popular and easiest use for banana peels is to mix them into the compost pile. Peels add potassium and phosphorus to compost, which promote root development and overall plant health when incorporated into garden soil. 2. Brew some compost tea. If you don't have a compost pile, you can still use banana peels to feed your garden. Simply drop a few peels into a bucket full of water and let it sit for a couple of days to make compost tea. Mix 1 part banana peel compost tea with 5 parts fresh water and feed this mineral-rich mixture to your plants about once per week in lieu of your normal watering. The added potassium and phosphorus will give your plants a boost to keep them growing strong. 3. Dried peel fertilizer. You can dry your banana peels and grind them into a fertilizer. If you only have a few peels to use up, but want to use them effectively on many plants, this is a great option. Add to your garden soil directly, either by sprinkling as a side dressing or gently incorporating into the dirt. 4. Create a banana peel spray. This spray is a fertilizer that also uses eggshells for a calcium boost and Epsom salt for magnesium. To create the fertilizer spray, you'll need banana peels, eggshells, Epsom salt, and water. Dry the banana peels and eggshells, then once they're dry, grind them together. Add the peels and shells to a spray bottle, along with the Epsom salt, and fill the sprayer to the top. Spray on your plants as needed. 5. Livestock feed. Humans are not the only ones who enjoy bananas. Livestock like chickens, rabbits, and pigs will enjoy ground up dried banana peels added to their feed. Just make sure to clean the peels of any wax or pesticides before drying and offering them to pets or livestock. And 6. Create banana peel vinegar. Blueberries and other acid-loving plants will enjoy a treat of banana vinegar. Put your peels in a mason jar, and cover with enough water so they're submerged. Cover with cloth and rubber band or a loosely fitting top. Let the mixture sit for a week while the good bacteria does its job and unlocks the nutrients in the peel. After a week, remove the peels, and allow the water to sit, covered, until the mixture ferments into a vinegar. This can take anywhere from 4 to 6 weeks, depending on conditions such as temperature. If the mixture seems especially potent, dilute it with water right before using so you don't accidentally burn your plants. Now, if you know any other uses of banana peels, please share them in the comments below. For homemade organic pesticide, every gardener must know. Homemade organic pesticide, aphids, spider mites, and other pests can cause serious damage to flowers, fruits, and vegetables. These creatures attack your garden in swarms, literally draining the life from your crops and often inviting disease in the process. Many chemical pesticides can prove unsafe for the environment or may make fruits and vegetables unsafe for consumption, however. Thankfully, there are many homemade, organic options for you to turn to in your war against pests. Remedy 1. Using chilies and garlic, combine 1/2 cup, 113 grams, of hot peppers with 1/2 cup, 113 grams, of garlic cloves or onions. You may also use both onions and garlic. All the vegetables should be chopped prior to use. Blend the vegetables together in a blender to form a thick, chunky paste. Add the vegetable paste to half a liter of warm water, mixing the ingredients together thoroughly. Pour the solution into a plastic or glass container and allow it to sit for 24 hours. If possible, keep it in a sunny location. If not, at least keep the mixture in a warm spot. Next, pour the solution through a strainer, removing the vegetables and collecting the vegetable-infused water into another container. This water is your pesticide. Pour your pesticide into a squirt bottle and spray on the affected plants. Remedy 2: using orange peels, peel an orange and place the peels into a glass container and pour 2 cups, 500 milliliters, of boiling water over the peels, allowing the solution to sit in a warm spot for 24 hours. Next, pour the solution into a strainer, removing the peels and saving the citrus-infused water. Add a few drops of castile soap. Peppermint-scented castile soap may prove especially effective. Mix the solution thoroughly to combine. Pour the pesticide into a large squirt bottle and spray the entire plant to ward off most soft-bodied pests. Remedy 3: using neem, combine 15 milliliters of neem oil with 1/2 teaspoon mild soap. Many believe neem oil, which comes from a bitter tree leaf, to be one of the most effective natural pesticides in existence. Mix the neem and soap into 2 liters of warm water, stirring slowly but thoroughly. Pour the pesticide into a spray bottle and spray on spots where you can clearly see pests or signs of pests. Remedy 4: using tobacco. Mix 1 cup of tobacco into 2 liters of water. Sit the mixture out in the sun or in warm location, allowing it to rest for 24 hours. Check the color of the mixture. Ideally, the pesticide will look similar to the hue of a light tea. If it is too dark, dilute it with water. If it is too light to see, allow it to sit an additional few hours. Add 3 tablespoons of mild liquid dish soap to the solution and mix thoroughly. Pour the mixture into a large squirt bottle. Shake the solution inside the bottle once more to combine it further and spray on affected plants. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you want more recipes and tips, subscribe to the channel.